students, I am Safiya, your science teacher. I hope everyone is doing well and taking care of yourselves. As it is rainy season, be careful, do not have any drinks which are cold and do not spoil your health. So today, let us start a new lesson. Small discussion here. Students, have you ever went out for any party or for something? Yeah, obviously you'll be going out. So what kind of clothes do you wear? Do you wear a uniform while you're attending any party? No, obviously not. Then when you're attending the school, are you going to wear your party wear dresses? No, you have a particular uniform here, right? In the same way, in the night time when you are going to sleep, what kind of dress you wear? Will you have your jeans and will you have your heavy dresses, or will you be having your night dress like you'll be having t-shirts or the pants or casuals, right? So that means according to the place and according to the occasion, we'll use different kinds of clothes. So that which we are discussing is the right clothes to wear. As I said, according to the occasion, we use different kinds of clothes. We wear different kinds of dresses or the attire. So first of all, how these have been invented? Before the discovery of the clothes, people used to have the clothes made up of leaves. You know, you have seen about early man or Tarzan, we can say. You can see in the old Jungle Book. You have seen the cartoon Jungle Book. In that, Mowgli will be, okay, a small kid will be. What clothes he'll be wearing? He'll be wearing the clothes made up of the leaves. That is what before, when they realized that we need to wear the dresses, they were not proper. Clothes were not there. Material was not there. Using that material, how the cloth can be made, they have no idea. So what they have done, they have plucked the leaves of the trees and they started making the clothes of them. And after making the clothes, they started using the clothes. And as we know, we have improved ourselves from early man. Now we are in the stage, we are able to explore each and everything present in the universe. So how later on they have discovered or they have found out about the materials which are used for making the clothes. So there are the two types of materials which are used for making cloth. Or I can say there are two types of fibers, that are natural fibers and artificial fibers. So natural fibers, these are obtained from the plants and animals. So let us discuss about these fibers in detail. You know, as I said, natural fibers are obtained from plants. Example of the fabric which is obtained from the plant is cotton. Cotton is obtained from the plant. Cotton flour, which is a cotton flour, will be used. The fibers from the flour will be taken and that fibers will be made into the cloth fabric. And from that fabric, we are able to stitch different types of dresses or the patterns. In the same way, one more is the woolen clothes. You know, woolen clothes are also natural fibers. They are obtained from the animal. Which animal will give us the wool? That is what? Sheep, goat, camel, yak, all these are the animals which have more hair on their body. And that hair is nothing but the wool. That hair is removed from the body of the animal and by some process will be getting the woolen clothes. So silk is also a kind of natural fiber. In the same way, artificial fibers. Artificial fibers are also called as synthetic fibers. Synthetic. Artificial fibers are also called as synthetic fibers. So these are obtained from the chemicals. These artificial fibers are polyester, nylon, acrylic. These are obtained from the chemicals. When two or three or more than chemicals are combined together, they will give out a fabric. That fabric is nothing but the artificial fiber or the artificial fabric. And we accord, why do we wear clothes actually? We have discussed the occasions and the types of fibers. But why do we wear the clothes? Yes, the basic thing. What is the need of clothes? Like, why do we need food? To get energy, right? What is the basic answer for that? To get energy. We fulfill our stomach with the food to get energy. To do all kind of activities, we need energy. We get energy from the food which we are eating. In the same way how food and house are important, in the same way clothes are also important. Because, for example, okay, for example, when you are a small kid, obviously you won't be having that much of sense of clothing and all. Your mama will be covering you. But when you have grown up, without dress and neck, you can't come out of your house. That is what? Because it looks bad. So clothes are the symbol of modesty. By wearing clothes, you look good. Okay, you look respectful when you are wearing the clothes. That is what modesty. Next one, in case of protection, you'll be protected from the different weather conditions. For example, when it is more cool, what do you feel more cool? So if you are wearing full clothes and your body is covered with the clothes, you won't feel cool. Next, in the summer season, as you know, the people who go out and work in the sunlight, continuous sunlight will be present. So the cloth, the area which is not covered with the cloth will be getting black. It will become black. That is what tanning. Tanning of the skin will take place. So that tan will take place because of the sunlight is falling there, and because of that, other part will be as usual. That is with that, by this you can say that clothes will also protect us from the heat, cold, and the insect bites. Usually mosquitoes, you know, in our house we have mosquitoes. Where mosquitoes will bite? Commonly on the face, on the hands, okay, and on the feet, where it is not covered with the clothes. But if your body is covered with the clothes, then mosquitoes may not bite you. So that means they will protect us from the insect bites or the mosquito bites as well. So these are the different uses of the clothes. First of all, clothes are the symbol of modesty. Modesty means to look good, to look respectful, we use the clothes. And then they protect us from the cool, they protect us from the heat, they protect us from the insect bites, and as well as from dust. You know, you need to wash your hands again and again. That is because this part of your hands will not be covered with the cloth. For example, now you can take my example. I am wearing my blazer up to here. So that means, for example, if I don't have gloves, then I need to wash my hands, because after some time dust will be forming here. Dust particles will be settling on my hand. It will look dirty. So what happens here? Because I'm wearing these clothes, my body is protected from the dust. So clothes will also protect us from the dust particles and germs. Germs cannot enter easily. If we are wearing the clothes, they need to enter through our clothes, then through our body. And in rainy season, what we'll wear in rainy season to protect ourselves from the rain? We wear raincoat to protect ourselves from the rainfall. Raincoat is made up of special fabric. That fabric is waterproof. Waterproof means water cannot come through that fabric. It cannot be absorbed by the fabric. So raincoat is made up of waterproof fabric. We use different types of clothes in different seasons. Just now, as I said, in rainy season, when we are going out, usually we use raincoat. Umbrella and raincoat are used in the rainy season. And whereas cotton dresses are used in the summer season, because cotton dresses are good, we feel comfortable, we feel cool when we are wearing the cotton dresses. And the same way in winter we wear woolen clothes. Woolen clothes will protect us from the cold. Okay, woolen clothes will trap the heat in them, and as they're trapping means they are holding the heat in them. If the heat is holding inside, we won't feel cool in our surroundings. So different clothes are used in different season. Raincoat is used in rainy season, whereas cotton clothes are used in rainy season, in summer season, but usually and more those are used in the summer season. Whereas in woolen clothes are used only in the winter season, right? And it is very, very important to know when and where we can use these clothes. For example, in summer season, if you wear woolen clothes, what will happen? you feel hot. In the same way, in winter season, instead of wearing woolen clothes, do you think you'll be protected from the rainfall? No, you won't be protected. So, to protect ourselves from the cold, we use woolen clothes. To protect ourselves from the rainfall, we use raincoat. So, there is a difference here, and it is very, very important to choose the type of the pattern of the dress in the season. We have discussed about the seasons. Now, the clothes when we have to wear at what time? For example, when you are coming to school, what do you wear? You wear a uniform. That is a special dress. It resembles or it shows that from which school you are belonging to. In the same way, when you are going out for a picnic, you will be wearing common t-shirts and the trousers. It's your wish. Whatever you want to wear, you can wear that. When you are going out for a picnic, when you are attending any function, you will be wearing a party wear, which are heavily designed for girls, and designer dresses and trousers and all for the boys. And when you are going for the sports, you will wear this all heavy dresses. No, you won't be wearing. You'll be wearing the t-shirts and the suits, which are, for example, if you're going for the gym, you'll be wearing sweat suit. So sweat will be coming, okay, that kind of dresses. And if you're going for a swimming, you'll be using swimsuit. You won't be wearing heavy dresses when you're going for a swimming. So it is very, very important to select the type of cloth and the fabric and what time you have to wear it. So this was the lesson. This was how we can choose a fabric, at what occasion, what kind of fabric or what kind of cloth should be worn by us. Students, your worksheet is to write what are natural fibers and why do we need clothes. The fibers which are obtained from the nature, that is from plants and animals, are called as natural fibers. Why do we need clothes? We need clothes to protect ourselves from heat, cold, rainfall, insect bites, dust, germs, and to protect, to look beautiful, we wear clothes. These are the answers which you have to write here. I hope you have understood the lesson clearly and properly, and we have more half of the lesson which will continue in the next session of the video. So go through the video thoroughly and properly and complete your answer sheet. Thank you. Bye-bye.